Hello everyone. So we're going to be creating a quiz game with Python today. So it's just going to be a quick project we're going to be creating with Python. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, Code with Drex. Now let's just see who want to print out first. Welcome to my quiz game. We could run this now and see, okay. We are getting it out here. Welcome to my quiz game. And then next, we want to print out, do you want to play? Just asking the player. Do you want to play? So now we're asking the player, do you want to play? So we want to collect an input from the user now. And what's the input? We want to have like, okay, let us have reply here. Reply equals to input. Enter yes to play and no to quit. So we want to make sure we have space here, because if we don't have space here, we see that Python is going to be prompting from the user, and the user is going to be typing exactly after the letter T or it start after the colon. So we want to have this space here to make sure that it is not like prompting immediately after the colon. So if we should run this now, we see that now we're having this space here. That's because we added it here. So now we could just input yes and press enter. But now we know when we are collecting the input, we are not doing anything with it. So to work with that, now we want to check if reply is equal to what? Is equal to yes. And if it's equal to yes, we want to continue. Then else, let me just put pass now. Then else, what do we want to do? We want to quit this. So if I should run this now, see that yes, the reply is okay. Okay, let me just say instead of pass here, let's have it here. Let's print yes. And let me run this again now. Now, if you should have yes here, we are printing yes. But if I should run this again and the user input no here, we are quitting the game immediately. But there is one problem here now. Let's say the user enter capital letter Y now, yes. We are quitting the game. So to work with this now, we need to make sure that we are converting this reply to a lower case and we are comparing it to this. To do that, we just call a function called lower here. So when it's comparing it, it's going to make sure that every input is comparing is going to be in lower case. So just like this is how we are going to like have it now. So if I should enter my capital letter, all my letters in capital letter, we are still getting our yes back. This is because automatically it's converting this to lower case before it's comparing it with this. So let's continue. So now we want to have a list of questions. So I just like to define a variable here, a list of. So we also have a list of questions here. So let us have questions. And this is going to be a list. And it's going to be a list of dictionary. So we are going to have a question. Then, after the question, we're going to have options, right? Then after the option two, the option two is going to be a list. Then after this option, we want to have the answer. So this, our list is going to be in this format. It's going to be in this format. We are going to have more of this. So now let's just say the first question now is, okay, let's say, what is the capital of France? This is the first question now. And now what do you want our options to be? Our options to be, okay, we want it to be like, okay, we want to have A, London. Okay, that's the first option. They want to have B. Want to have B, Berlin. Then what do you want to have again? We want to have C, Paris. Then we want to have the last option, which is option D. We want to have room. So now this is all our options now. I want to have the answer also. Now the answer is C, which is Paris, right? We want to store that. So we are going to have more questions. Like, let me just create like two more questions to make this a total of three. So half comma here. Let's paste this. Half comma here. Let's paste this. And let's just change this question and then. Okay. Let's see. Which language is primarily used for web development. So we asked which of this language is primarily used for web development. I want to have Python. Then option B, we want to have JavaScript. So now I want to have C++. And the last option, I want to make it Java. So now what's the answer here now? Answer is option B, right? So let's go to the last question. Okay, let's have what is the largest planet in our solar system? So I want to have the first option here. Let's say we have Earth, and now we're having the second option to be Jupiter. And let's have the third option to be Saturn. Then we have Mars. So we have this as B. So now we have our list of questions ready. So we have our list of questions ready. So now let's just define a function here to ask these questions. I'll call this ask questions. Okay, ask question. And it's going to have an argument question, which is going to be the list of this question now. So we want to print out. So, I want to print out question. Want to print out question. Question. So, this is going to be this list. And now, we are printing out the question of this list here. All right, when we are running it now, we understand it more. Let me just continue for now. So now for option in question. That's option. Want to print out each of the options. Then, want to have our answer equals to input your answer. So we are prompting the user for answer now. They want to make sure that the user know the available option. B, C, and D. So these are the available options we want the user to, we are expecting from the user. So we want to return if answer now is equal to question answer. So we want to return this. Now this is going to be giving us either true or false. So we are going to have another function here, and this is going to be the function that will be running like the quiz itself. So this is our function run quiz now. We want to have questions here. I want to have our score. So let's just set the score to 0 by default. And one thing is that we don't want these questions to just be like running the way they are. So we want to shorten the question and make sure that it's not running like this first and this second and this third. So we're going to import a module called random here. So let's call that random. So after we import random here now, we are going to call it here. So what we are going to say is now random dot shuffle questions. So these are a list of questions here now. So now for question in questions. So now we are looking through this list now for question in questions. So question now is each of these. This is a question. This is a question. For question in questions, we are looking through this full list itself now, getting each question itself. Then what we want to do with that question now, when we have a particular question, we want to ask this question. So now we are calling this now. So we want to ask that question. So now we are calling the question now. If you look at this, our function ask question now, we are taking the question, we are printing the question. So now this is a key. So these are keys now, and these are the values. We are giving it the key, and now we want the values to be printed out. So it's going to print out the values now. Now we are now looking through the options in the questions. So in that particular question now, we are looking through the option. Let's say now this is the question now. We are looking through this option now, and we're printing out the option. Then this is how we are printing out the question options. So now we want to compare the answer now. We are like collecting answer from the user now. So when we collect the answer now, we are going to compare this answer with this answer here. So we are identifying that, okay, we are telling Python now, for this particular question, check the answer. So this is the key now. We are checking the answer. We are checking the value of the answer. And we are comparing it if it's equal to the answer the user inputted. So one thing we are going to do is how to convert this to upper. So that we want to convert this to upper. So that whichever input the user have is going to be converted to an uppercase. Just as we did with this place here. So that it will be right. So whenever this is returning true, what do you want to do? We want to print out correct. And let's have this on new line. But else, okay, after I print out correct, we want to increase our score by 1. Then what do you want to do? Else, we want to print out wrong. Wrong. Then we want to give the user the correct answer. The correct answer was. So now we are using a formatted string here so that we can be able to have this variable in an easy way inside here. I want to assess the value of that particular question. So because of this formatted string, that's why we're able to like assess this value by just using curly braces. So I want to print this out. Then after this for loop, we want to print out. You got the user score out of the length of the question. So I want to print it out of the length of the questions. Out of the length of the questions. So this should be a formatted string. So we're going to have our questions here. So I want to print out of the length of the questions. Now, here now, we want to call this run quiz question. Just going to have it as, okay. Let's run the quiz. I want to give it these questions here. So we could go and try this out now. Okay. Let's say yes, I want to play this. Okay, now it's asking us now, what is the largest planet in our solar system? And we can see now, it really shuffled the question, because the first question here is actually, what is the capital of France? But now it's asking us what is the largest solar system. So now, the largest solar system is Jupiter. So I would like to enter B now. And okay, tells me that I am correct, because I enter B. Don't forget that I enter small letter B, right? And it's comparing it to its uppercase. But because we converted this to an uppercase here before the comparison is able to do it well. So now, what is the capital of France? Capital of France now is what? Okay, let me intentionally fail this now. So now, yes, wrong. The correct answer was C. So that was the correct answer now. So which language is primarily used for web development? So now, let me get this right again. Correct now. So I got 2 out of 3. So this is how to create a simple quiz project with Python. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.